interesting, very interesting. You want to know how far we've gone, whether we make any progress, whether we can detect any progress that we've made. What is it like? After years of practice, well, in the beginning, it is a lot of sitting meditation, a lot of developing the mind. It's only when the mind is calm that we probably have a chance to see, to have an insight, to see what's coming up, see what's the cause of what's coming up. If you do not see the cause, you do not know the solution, it's through seeing, the cause that we come to know that we have a delusive view of something. We are holding on something which we should not be holding to. That something which we are holding is something worse than that. It is not even real. It's something we have created. And our creating of that thing that we are holding on to is due to our conditioning, nothing else. So, somewhere, somehow, in the practice, there must be some progress in our training of the mind and heart. So, what do we look for? Well, one of the first things is relinquishment of self. I've explained before what self is like. It's something that we created. So we do not believe or hold on to this sense of self very strongly. We, every time we come across and hold on to this, it's me. We realize that, well, this me is created by this conditioning. I should not believe strongly in this me, right? Because it's my conditioning, right? So we come to learn to let go, to relinquish this idea, this belief of the self. Because this believing of the self causes a lot of suffering. As being as you know, different ideas, you know, something happening to me, you know, all suffering. It comes with identifying yourself with an identity. That identity is what we make of yourself. Or even identifying with an identity of somebody else. He is like that. He's not going to change. He's always been like that. He will be like that. Maybe true. May not be true. We have come to know that sometimes certain things happen in a person's life and they change totally. So where has that self gone to? So this self-identity, or the identity of something else, this identity, it's not real. So one of the progress that we have is we have this relinquishment of the self. From this relinquishment of the self, we have wisdom, insight. That's the second thing that we have, insight into things as they are, inside into what we holding on to. We come to know that most of the things that we hold on to, that we are attracted to, that we are averse to, are not the thing itself, but identity. The identity is causing all the problems. So that's the second thing we realize as we go into our practice. Yeah. We're able to relinquish the self faster, more insight into the nature of things, that's wisdom. And all this doesn't happen within month or 2 months, you know. It does, maybe 6 months, you can see a lot different. You feel a bit more free, a bit more light, right? You feel a lightness in yourself. You know, you feel a bit more relaxed. You don't feel a too up time. And all the other things, so you can feel yourself not holding on to things. And another thing that you will find is that you will have more energy. Right? You'll have more energy because you do not start losing your energy by worrying about things, by complaining about things within your mind, by all the preoccupation with things you like, preoccupation with things you like, by wanting more, by trying, putting effort into wanting something different, by wanting to get rid of things, by losing your energy in all these ways. So you find yourself more energy. Another thing is that the energy saved will be put into the effort in your practice. So you realize that this is a good path that will bring benefit. You also find another quality, that's the quality of patience. Right? When you come to see things, that things that we come to see is something that we make up, it is an identity, then we have more patience. We don't treat it personal. Right? You don't see, well, this person is trying to get on my nerves. Right? We come to see it as a process, that this person is conditioned. He's conditioned in a particular way. You know, he's fixed on something. He may not like your attitude, whatever. That's his condition. So we come to see things as a process. We are more patient. More patient with things. So that is the progress that we can identify. And one of the most important progress is knowing the truth. What is the truth? It's the Four Noble Truths. Four Noble Truths, the first truth is we know that there is this dissatisfaction. That's why it's dissatisfaction. When we hold on to things, it falls away, it doesn't last. What happens then? Yeah. Our body doesn't last. Sometimes relationship doesn't last. Families doesn't last. All things doesn't last. Satisfaction. And very come to know that if you want to hold on to things that are holy God or something that's permanent, the one thing to the desire to crave it for, that's the cause of suffering. We see it clearly to our practice. We come to know it from direct experience, rather from something telling you. But that comes with a trained heart to see, really see the cause of suffering. Identifying the essence of attached to things that compare with living with it. Oh, I want to be with this thing that I like. I'm protective of this thing that I like. It causes a problem. Right? So it creates a problem. It creates all this problem. It brings suffering. Thing you like, long for the thing you like, comparing your way with the thing you like, when it gets stolen, whatever, disappear. That causes suffering because of disattention. Then we come to realize that the practice that we've been doing, that's the power, that's useful. That we come to realize the power. The correct path. The letting go of this attachment, letting go of this craving. So we have a path for it. The path involves sitting and doing your meditation, developing your heart, developing your mind. From there, the insight comes in. From the inside, your behavior changes. You become less attached to things. When you become less attached to things, you are more ethical. You do not break the five precepts because you want something. You don't steal things. Even from the office, a pen or something, a craving is there. It's okay, I can do it down there. So you stop telling lies. That's the changes as well. Right? So, because you don't have this strong sense of self, you have to protect yourself by telling lies. Yeah. You accept that you have this condition. Yeah. So you become a bit more loose and you become a bit more moral. Thinking of yourself. That's one of the benefits. But that's actually a real benefit. Becoming a more moral person is happiness. The happiness comes from not having any remorse. Not having to think, I should have done that, why did I do that? What's the result? What have I got? What's the result of that? And so on and so on. So keeping your precepts, morality, when you have that, your mind's at ease, you do not have any guilt, and you get happiness out of that. Just happiness from being good, a sense of happiness. And that happiness is not because you've done anything, but because you are a moral person, or you have a little bit of purity in yourself. Right? The happiness comes from that purity. People are happy with you. Right? People respond to you, people trust you. Right? People like you, people admire you. It's very difficult to be a moral person. A good person, a person who keeps peace. Yeah. But progress, you can see your progress. either way, they can become a more ethical person. So knowing your truth is important. Give you the satisfaction, the cause of the dissatisfaction. And then the power towards ending of this dissatisfaction. You will not come, you will know that you will know the end, cessation of craving. It's a little kind of place. So when you're sitting there, not wanting anything, there's this place. You're happy. Mind's calm. Mind's not seeking anything. And seeking is going on. Looking. And because of the practice, you have this determination, strong determination. You have this strong determination because it overcomes hindrances that prohibit you from carrying the task that you want to do. You know you have to do this. Then, it's too hard, I can't do it. That's a kind of thing. And then you think, I'm not sure whether I can be successful in doing it. And you dislike it. It's all changes. So you find that when you want to do something, you're determined to do something, you go and do it. Right? Without these hindrances coming to block, without this laziness, doubt, restlessness. And you find that because you understand identity, you understand that how you see people is your own creation, then it's easier for you to develop goodwill to others. You have practiced metta, loving kindness, goodwill to others. Can change the identity. Right? So the person doesn't have to change. You have to change your identity of the person. You just have to change the things, the awful things that they created in the person. The aversion they created in the person. You can change that. You can have loving kindness, metta for the person. The next one is you have more kindness. Because of your calm, you know that liking and disliking comes from your conditioning, your previous conditioning. Continuing to like things. The reason why you like something is because you have invested in the identity of something special, something good. When you come to see that, then you know that you're just falling over your own creation. It's not more than that. Right? Once you understand that, then you can become more equanimous. Right? So if you're given something which you don't like, you don't have any strong aversion to it. If you're given something that you like, you're not overjoyed with it. Right? Because you know it's something that you make up. how you see the things, how you make it up, the condition. So you can be happy with whatever you're given. You can be happy in whatever situation you're in. And you can even be happy with whatever mindset that you have. There is one thing that we have to add on to the practice, to our practice. That is generosity. We have to practice the rather the development, because attachment is the opposite of generosity. Difficult to get rid of attachment, get rid of craving. We cannot go craving arises, we can act on it. But if we practice generosity, then we are really practicing something that's opposite. We are countering our desire for pain. Countering our craving. We are developing something opposite. Give it. Oh, I want to give. If I don't have it anymore, people can't get rid of it. The garage is full of stuff, the cupboard is full of stuff, the room is full of stuff, the kitchen is full of stuff. They can't give it a chair. So maybe one day I'll need it, I don't know, 6 months. Or maybe my son needs it, or my grandson needs it. No. It's attachment. You know? Don't need it. Get it away. One less thing to worry. Less clutter. Don't trip over. You don't see the dust accumulating on it. You make someone else happy. That's the thing. Maybe a charity shop, somebody's happy. Yeah. Somebody, oh yeah, I've got this crystal glass for 10p. Whoa. Right? It's happy. Somebody happy. Right? Whereas you're sitting on your dental piece, you've got this dental seat and you're pretty much break, all sorts of things. Generosity works against touching. So what I've been talking about is an attribute of perfection. Buddhism is called param perfection. Now all these attributes or characteristic, or however you want to call it, is practiced by the Buddha. It's practiced by the Vajika Buddha, practiced by the Arahant. So you have to develop these 10 param. It can be developed into perfection. We develop it through meditation. And in our daily life as well, you know, we can check ourselves when we're not patient. You know, we can waste energy, effort to do our practice. Try to keep our precept. try to speak the truth. So, try to let go of the self. Every time we think about ourselves, look at it. Not just mulling over this identity. Let's start mulling over somebody's behavior. Look at it, let go. Relinquish it. So, let go of it. Patience. Patience. Develop patience. Watch ourselves. Watch when we are not patient. We need this in a hurry. We can't see the person is doing this thing very slowly. Practice patience. Just walk. Just walk. And say, I all the time. I can't wait. Be outside yourself when you're doing something. Try to slow down. Try to do it a little bit better when you reach the reach of things. And then we can, in our practice, we put in the determination to sit for half an hour, sit for 3/4 of an hour, sit every day. Sit when we are tired, sit when we are sleeping, sit when we have no time. That's the definition you have to put in our practice. We do a loving kindness practice that I've taught you all, with a smile on the heart, or any other loving kindness practice, any good loving practice. The change of the identity that we accumulated in our mind, all the undesirable identity, all the identity that we dislike, all the identity that we are first to change. Then we try to move into a position of equanimity. When we come to see somebody who is shouting at us, being angry at us, we move to a position of equanimity. Right? We can say that this person is cough out in this condition. Right? So we move in the position of the body and know that this person is caught out in this condition. Keep noticing that. Right? And he is angry, not with this body, not with this person. He's angry with the identity he created of this person. So it's an angry of something that he created, which is formed. So he moved in that position. There's something we learn to practice. We have to practice. And that's also something that comes out of our practice. So all these 10 paramis comes out of our practice. We know, we go through it, we effort in developing these 10 parameters as well. 10 perfect, 3 attributes of perfect. So what else is there? Beyond that, beyond what we can see, actually totally change of the level of consciousness. That happens when we have seen through the view of sound, and the inside of the view of sound, and we know that that actually isn't a permanent self. In us and in others, something that we create. And that comes from the breakthrough. That breakthrough that you changes your consciousness into what they call a stream enter. Now, I do not want to talk about those different noble paths. You can find out about them. It's just a description of it. That comes with the progress of the practice. When you get there, well, you know, and you want to try to get there, that's good. Right? So long as you put your effort doing the right practice, doing the right training, doing the right treating correctly, then you will come to have this breakthrough. When you have come to have this breakthrough, you will come. But developing and noticing all these 10 harmonies. And by noticing it, you know that you have progress. By looking at it, you know what you still have to do. So that is an important part of the practice. Harmonies, developing harmonies. Because that will change your practice quickly. As you progress, all of these will become slightly uneven, right? So you will notice what is it that you're lacking behind when you practice that. Don't have patience, but practice patience. Patience, if you don't have patience, it leads to anger. It's one cause of anger, impatience. There is a good way of cultivating patience. You just sit. Keep sitting. Keep sitting. An hour. Painful, keep sitting. Hour and a half, keep sitting. It's the thing. 2 hours, he keeps it. But that's the way, that's one way of doing it. That's how the forest tradition of Theravada Buddhism. He keeps it. So you bear the pain, right? So you're patient. Oh, it's painful, you know, you bear it. Oh, it's very painful. You can bear with extreme pain. Right. Constantly practice that. Then when you see somebody, you know, doing something, that's nothing. Nothing compared to what you've gone through. Tremendous pain. Right? Okay, that's annoying. Right? But it's extreme pain, you know, so mind-blowing or pain, body splitting pain. So when somebody annoys you, nothing. So it's everything, it's relative. Relative to what you've experienced. suggested. So it's up to you whether you want to do it, but you feel that you have to practice patience. There's no other way of practicing patience. Do you want to go try this one? Okay? Another one which you have to practice is loving kindness, goodwill. Because you have to have there are people who are what you call hate type people, or people who dislike this, dislike that. You know, if you're one of those people, then it's good to do the practice, create that smile, bring up all the identities of the people you don't like, change their identity. And you see when you see the person, the feeling for the person changes. Because when you see the person, you're projecting identity to the person. And when you're feeling for the person changes, person's feeling for you changes as well. It's like, hey, somebody is so good with me. Yeah, it's changed. I like it now. You know? So, you have done nothing. All you have to do is change your own identity. And you realize it's true. Yeah? Generosity, metta, patience. Those are the things that's most practiced. Of course, your meditation comes from.